In this video, I'm going to show you how I combine 3D printing, 3D scanning, and silicone molding to create these. Fully custom, safe in your body earplugs designed for my very own ear canals, and I'm going to show you how you can make your very own as many pairs as you want for pennies a set. Hey there everyone, Jonathan Levy here, and I have to say, I'm surprised to be making this video. In a previous video I did on one of my biggest projects to date, a 3D printed camera crane jib, I asked you all to let me know in the comments if you'd be interested in seeing how I made my very own custom tailored earplugs built for my own ear canal. And if I'm honest, I really didn't think many people would be that into it. But I probably underestimated just how much you guys love making stuff, and probably if you're like me, that means that you make a lot of noise. Now, I don't know about all of you, but my ears are really, really important to me, and not just because I work in content creation. I've had a couple of pretty serious ear trauma incidents where friends have peer pressured me to take out my ear protection at concerts, and to this day, I live with the consequences. My ears consistently ring, and just this week, I had to go for probably the 10th different ear test to diagnose a strange and elusive problem where my brain can no longer differentiate speech when there's background noise. I tell you all this for one simple reason, to urge you, whether you're using the hammer drill or going to the firing range or just heading out to a nightclub, please wear ear protection, people. Once you mess up your eardrums, there's not much you can do about it, and even the best solutions out there are really nowhere near as good as just having healthy eardrums. I hope you guys will take my word for it rather than learning the hard way. Okay, so let's get into the video by first talking about earplugs, because of course the best ear protection out there means these big, nasty, earmuffy type things, but let's face it, those aren't practical or stylish in most situations. There is, of course, the foam ones, but let's be honest, those suck. And then there's the ones that I use for many, many years, these silicone putty type ones that you roll up and try to squish into your ear. Now, there are a few problems with these. I mean, they aren't super comfortable. They attract dust like crazy if you sleep with them or use them in the workshop, and they don't work all that well. Plus, at a few bucks a pair, they really start to add up when you're using them all the time, which I hope you will be. Now, for all of these reasons and many, many more, a few years ago, I decided to bite the bullet and make a big investment of a couple hundred dollars and get some custom-made acrylic earplugs, the exact same kind that you see professional musicians using. This involves having my ear molded with that kind of fast-set putty that you see at the dentist, and then sending that out to a lab for scanning, after which I received a lovely set of acrylic plastic earplugs. Now, these earplugs were really great, except one of them didn't really sit right, causing it to slip out all the time. Truthfully, because they were smooth acrylic, they both kind of slipped out a millimeter or so every once in a while, forcing me to kind of push them back in every few hours. Now, I lived with this for a year or two, and then I decided to call the company, which was kind enough to let me come in and get them modified. They added some acrylic on top of it, and then a friction coating, and finally, my earplugs were perfect, until I lost them about a week later. Yes, one day I went to a concert, and before the concert even started, I noticed that they had slipped out of my pocket. Darn. Now, my options at this point were to spend hundreds of dollars to get another set, even though I'd already had the moldings done, or to try and make my very own. And since this time around I had my own 3D printer, I decided to try out the latter option. I remember back to when I first ordered, and I had the option of hard acrylic, which was better for concerts and stuff like that, and silicone, which was better for sleeping on them, but still pretty good for construction work and concerts and stuff like that. Therefore, I knew that these two types of materials would be safe in my ears as long as I used high-quality polymers. Now, I don't know how to work with acrylic, so I decided to go with the silicone option since anyways, I always found the acrylic a bit uncomfortable during flights and stuff and when I tried to sleep on the earplugs. Where I live, as I've said before, it's pretty hard to find maker materials like this, and it's also really expensive, so Believe it or not, I actually found a supplier for food grade silicone right on AliExpress. This stuff is not only safe for use around the body, but it's also clear, fume free, and has none of the nasty stuff that this high heat silicone does that would honestly burn your skin. I'll link to it in the description below. Hopefully it's still available. Now, here's the part where I admit I sort of cheated. I was lucky enough to have paid for molding and 3D scanning when I originally bought those professionally made earplugs. So all I had to do was reach out to the company and ask them to send me the STL files, which they were kind enough to do. But before you get discouraged and write off the whole rest of this video, don't worry, because you can still do this at home by yourself without paying a professional to do it. And considering a custom set of earplugs are $159 to $200 online for each and every pair when you lose them, you'll still save a ton of money by doing it yourself. Plus, you'll be able to make a new set whenever you want, even if you don't lose them. The first thing you're going to need to do then is get a good impression of your inner ear. Now, there are actually 3D scanners that go inside your ear and do that, but practically, what you're gonna need is just to find a kit that's made with a material that is safe to use inside the body. I actually found a few online ranging from $25 to $35, and you simply follow the instructions and you'll get a proper cast of your inner ear. And it'll be exactly the same as the one that I got done by a professional, just for a whole lot less. And many of them even come with a lot of spare material in case you mess up. From there, with the model of your ear in hand, we need to get these shapes digitized. And here again, I'll admit that I cheated and I had this done professionally because at the time, I didn't have a 3D scanner. Now this means that I got a super accurate file to use without having to do all the legwork for it. But once again, this doesn't mean that you can't do this at home or that you need to pay to do it. In fact, with apps like Polycam and a little bit of tweaking in Blender, you can actually use your phone's camera and create pretty decent 3D models of your mold using a technology called photogrammetry. Best of all, because we own the 3D printer, you can print, cast, test, and modify over and over and over again until you get it right, meaning that your 3D scans don't have to be perfect at all. Heck, even my own professionally molded and scanned model was actually too small in my left ear, so I ended up modifying and scaling it up by 2 or 3% to get a nice tight fit. You could also just pay someone on Fiverr $5 to clean up your 3D scan for you if you're lazy and not super great at Blender. Now, if this sounds like too much work, you can do a couple of different things. You can either borrow a 3D scanner from a local makerspace or buy one if you're planning to use it for lots of stuff anyways, or you can just get these molds professionally scanned. Both of the earplug companies that I linked in the description below, which I'm not affiliated with in any way, sell those at-home molding kits and will probably be willing to do the scanning for you and send you the models for a lower price without having to buy the actual earplugs. But there are also companies out there like Exact Metrology that will just 3D scan any object you mail them. So at around $50, you're still saving money over buying just one pair of professional earplugs. But personally, I would just try to use photogrammetry and a lot of patience and try to get a really good scan. By the way, I actually own one of the popular 3D scanners on the market, the CR Scan Lizard, and I'd love to know in the comments below if you'd like me to do a video on that, reviewing it, and letting you know if it's worth buying or not. I have some very, very strong opinions. I'm just not sure if any of you are interested in 3D scanning. All right, by now, you hopefully have your very own ear canals 3D modeled on your computer, and that means we're on the home stretch. The next thing to do is just to model the mold so that you can pour your own silicone earplugs whenever you want. For this, I used Blender, but you can use any 3D design software out there with a Boolean function, which is basically the ability to cut one object out of the other. Check out any old tutorial on YouTube if you're not familiar with Blender, but it's really very easy to do. You can also do the same thing to cut out some letters so you know which side is left and which side is right during the molding. When doing the Boolean modifier, I positioned the earplugs in such a way that they would pull out with minimal resistance, but also I made sure that the butts of them were up facing. I did this not only because I wanted the inner part to be as perfect and smooth as possible, but also because I wanted to insert little 3D printed screws I had created using OpenSCAD into the butts during the molding process. Now, these screws theoretically serve multiple functions. First of all, they make it easier to turn the plugs, which require a twist to insert properly. Second, they give me something to grab onto to pull them out. And third, I actually set my printer to change the filament towards the end of the print so that there would be either a red or a blue dot deep inside the earplug. The idea behind this is that you can't see it when the earplug is inserted, but it lets me know which side should go in what ear. Truthfully though, in retrospect, I think the next set I make, I'll probably just drop in a tiny millimeter or two of red or blue filament and leave the screws off because the butts of the screws are actually the most visible part of the plug when they're inserted. They look a whole lot better without them, and I can usually get the earplug to come out with just my fingernail anyways. With the Boolean modifier in place creating a mold for us and the screws which I generated on OpenSCAD, all I had to do was print this whole thing out. Now make sure to use as low heat as possible to avoid stringing inside because you're not going to want to get a heat gun in there. And I recommend using pretty high resolution, such as 0.15 or even 0.1 millimeter layer height, and of course a 0.4 millimeter nozzle for the mold itself. Honestly, there's not much to say about this step. It goes really, really quickly and smoothly, and you can print the mold out of basic old PLA. All right, are you ready? It's time to test out your mold and see how well it fits. Simply mix up some of the two-part silicone, stirring gently to avoid any air bubbles, and pour it in the mold with something like a teaspoon, again, doing your best to avoid bubbles. And then, just wait. For the best fit, I did not put oil, soapy water, or Vaseline in the mold, which meant that it was a bit harder to pull out the plugs, but I think it was worth it to get the absolute tightest fit possible. Though you can definitely try putting soapy water in if you want to make the removal as easy as possible. That's definitely better than Vaseline, at least. I also recommend not putting in any screws the first time around if you are going to put them in at all, because you probably will need to make some adjustments to the fit, and you also just may not want to use screws. The screws take time and effort to change the filament, so probably during the practiced runs, I wouldn't include them at all. But based on what I said above about them not being useful, it's your call. You're probably wondering why I didn't print the initial prototypes out of flexible TPU filament instead of remolding and recasting them every single time. And the simple answer is, I did. I tried, and the resolution was not high enough. They were really stringy and nasty and unpleasant because that's how TPU is sometimes, and they really hurt my ears. So I gave up on that and decided just to reprint the mold since it doesn't use a lot of PLA and silicone is really cheap. Don't look at me like that. I promised you guys better camera angles and cooler shots once I had the micro jib set up, and I'm really enjoying it. Once you do get a good fit, all you need to do is wait till the silicone is semi-dry and insert in the screws if you want. I might recommend trying something else out though besides screws, such as a more intricate design that will get more surface area stuck inside the silicone, because my screws have been pulled out a few times and I've had to glue them in with epoxy to get them to stay. And also a bigger loop or handle on the outside would be much easier to grab onto. And honestly, that's it. I 3D printed a nice little case for my earplugs and I cleaned them with warm soapy water and they're done. We just need to pull them out, which hopefully shouldn't be too difficult, and trim them down once they're done. When I started this project, I was pretty sure it was going to be a fun learning experience, but that I would end up paying for another set of overpriced earplugs. But honestly, I was way wrong. Not only do these earplugs fit much better than the original set that I paid for, because I was able to tweak and expand and customize them to the parts that felt a little bit too loose, but they also are much, much more comfortable. Now, admittedly, the silicone is harder to put in than the acrylic was because it's kind of like shoving a jello shot in your ear as it squishes and gives while you try to turn it. But once they're in there, the sound deadening is so much better than the acrylic ones, likely because the fit is just so much better. They're way more comfortable to sleep with or keep in for long periods of time. And best of all, I can make each set of them for pennies every single time they get too dirty or I lose one. I can have a pair in my office, a pair near the bed, a pair in my travel bag, and a pair near my power tools if I want to, without spending $1,000 on earplugs. Now, while I fully understand that I sort of cheated in this project, I'd love to hear in the comments below how much success each one of you have with it. Let me know in the comments as well what you think. And again, please remember to like and subscribe because this is a new channel and it makes a huge difference when you engage with our videos. Thanks for watching and keep those eyes and ears safe.